Thinking about your friendship with Michael Jackson. I mean, that's another. I look at this picture of you in the background, and I mean, he just had everything. He was amazing, and he grew up before our very eyes. I know that you were very, very upset and very vocal about his death. It takes a lot to anger you.
The main thing that angered me about the death of Michael Jackson was the participation of enabling medical doctors. There's a whole culture of enabling doctors that not only get people addicted, but then perpetuate the addiction through legalized prescriptions. The number one cause of drug addiction in the world, in America particularly, is not street drugs through the agency of pushers. It's legal prescriptions written by people who have a license, medical license. So it's a huge problem, and now that problem is seeping not into the celebrity culture alone, but also into children. You know, an ongoing problem in the ages between 15 and 29 is prescription drugs that are given by physicians. So part of my anger, which was natural, was not only losing a friend, but knowing that the death of this tragic figure and good person was at least a collaboration, if not the direct result of enabling doctors. Michael was surrounded by a plethora of shameful enabling doctors. Now, as the investigation comes out, we'll learn more about this, which is not to say that Michael did not participate in this collaboration. Michael was a tortured soul. He had a complex history, complex childhood. He had a lot of stress as a result of always having to perform as a child star, and actually became such a huge mega figure that now that became his image and he had to live up to it.
You know, this question is not so funny for you, but I have to say this. Last day, the Michael Jackson's doctor was guilty by the jury in Los Angeles. You were a close friend with Michael Jackson, doctor. How do you feel with this sentence?
I think the sentence is correct, but you know, Dr. Murray is only one person. This is a whole cabal of very unethical doctors in Los Angeles, in Hollywood, who actually, for them it's a big business. There are pill factories that are owned by these doctors. They're supported by some of the drug companies. They initiate and then they perpetuate the addiction and celebrities, because this is, first of all, it's a good way to make money. Also, it becomes their identity to be linked with the celebrity. Dr. Murray is only one of them. It's not going to be, you know, I think unless the medical profession polices itself, the problem will go on.
Do you believe that the jury in LA gives the right to you? Because you were in a little controversy.
I was in the controversy in the beginning, but no, I think the jury validated what I was saying.
You know? And you said, this is a narcotic.
Yes.
This doctor is giving a narcotic to Michael.
Yes.
Because the abuse of this drug.
Yeah, the doctors are worse than the drug pushers, you know, this legalized drug pushers. There are more deaths from prescriptions now than from street drugs. In America, the number one cause of death is medical prescriptions, not street drugs, not drugs from Colombia or anywhere else or from Mexico. It's from medical doctors.
Then if we want to punish the dealers, they are not in Colombia or in Panama or in the Gulf of Mexico.
They are in the
medicine doctors.
Legal
doctors. Not only in the
even children now are getting medical prescriptions, narcotics. It's not all the doctors, but it's enough to cause the problem.